He then left to make his way as usual to the Mount of Olives, with the disciples following. When he reached the place, he said to them, "Pray not to be put to the test." Then he withdrew from them, about a stone's throw away, and knelt down and prayed. "Father," he said, "if you are willing, take this cup away from me. Nevertheless, let your will be done, not mine." Then an angel appeared to him, coming from heaven to give him strength. In his anguish he prayed even more earnestly, and his sweat fell to the ground like great drops of blood. When he rose from prayer, he went to the disciples and found them sleeping from sheer grief. "Why are you asleep?" he said to them. "Get up and pray not to be put to the test."
Thank you. when a number of men appeared, and at the head of them the man called Judas, one of the 12, who went up to Jesus to kiss him. Jesus said, "Judas, are you betraying the Son of Man with a kiss?" Then Jesus spoke to the chief priests and captains of the temple guard and elders who had come from him. "Am I a brigand," he said, "that you have to set out with swords and clubs?" They seized him and led him away. Peter followed at a distance. They had lit a fire in the middle of the courtyard, and Peter sat down among them. And as he was sitting there by the blaze, a servant girl saw him and said, "This person was with him too." But he denied it. Shortly afterwards, someone else saw him and said, "You are another of them." But Peter replied, "I am not, my friend." About an hour later, another man insisted, saying, "This fellow was certainly with him. Why, he is a Galilean." "My friend," Peter said, "I do not know what you are talking about." At that instant, while he was still speaking, the cock crew, and the Lord turned and looked straight at Peter. And Peter remembered that the Lord had said to him, "Before the cock crows today, you will have disowned me 3 times." And Peter went outside and wept bitterly.
Have mercy on me, and God, in your kindness, in your kindness.
summoned the chief priests and the leading men of the people. "You have brought this man before me," he said, "as a political agitator. Now I have gone into the matter myself, in your presence, and found no case against the man in respect of all the charges you bring against him. Nor has Herod either, since he has sent him back to us. As you can see, the man has done nothing that deserves death. So I shall have him flogged and then let him go." Pilate was anxious to set Jesus free, but they shouted back, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" And for the third time he spoke to them, "Why? What harm has this man done? I have found no case against him that deserves death, so I shall have him punished and then let him go." But they kept on shouting at the top of their voices, demanding that he should be crucified. Pilate then gave his verdict. Their demand was to be granted, and he handed Jesus over to them to deal with as they pleased.
Thank you.
Then they took charge of Jesus, and carrying his own cross, he went out of the city to the place of the skull, or as it was called in Hebrew, Golgotha, where they crucified him with two others, one on either side of Jesus. When the soldiers had finished crucifying Jesus, they took his clothing and divided it, one for each soldier. His undergarment was seamless, woven in one piece from neck to hem. So they said to one another, "Instead of tearing it, let's throw dice to decide who is to have it." In this way, the words of Scripture were fulfilled. "They shared out my clothing among them. They cast lots for my robes." Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. Seeing his mother and the disciple he loved standing near her, Jesus said to his mother, "Woman, this is your son." Then to the disciple he said, "This is your mother." And from that moment, the disciple made a place for her in his home.
Was ever Sicir fan sleep mordeth the forehead egumper and the precious of falling the dead fortune. But Yalman and Packing no feeling of broken, more hearts, no fall no. Hogather Lily mar hopeful at Poshta, Hather a macher flagging and strody. Er scorn the hog loon at the South Korea of our darling, Bully may fail, go snow bully my forehead, a small man made no maim of Poshta. Oh, haunts and no haunts. Hang leather sauce and brush for order. Could a pooky more must come and honor. Had them the shellish dass and I get the skin of their fake order. Dog of their own leg of four shape balls. Honic the beauty is father and loose and the holy and knobby. She leg of in your shell because Gulliki got harder. Honig na hangen is the little dog of Grote. Honig mordor van der Lennis, the valley sheep with Quillibus fjord and Walmas. Piacha gunna leinikus yomi van Groste. Femmer fuin mordor van der Lennis and drama of the Rona. Oh, homes, no, no.
When they reached the place called the Skull, they crucified him there, and the two criminals also, one on the right and the other on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them. They do not know what they are doing."
Which brought from them the news.
Thank you.
It was now about the sixth hour, and, with the sun eclipsed, a darkness came over the whole land until the ninth hour. The veil of the temple was torn right down the middle, and when Jesus had cried out in a loud voice, he said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." With these words, he breathed his last.